बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस इम्पल्स मोमेंटम इक्वेशन। इम्पल्स मोमेंटम इक्वेशन इज़ वन ऑफ द बेसिक टूल्स फॉर द सॉल्यूशन ऑफ फ्लो प्रॉब्लम्स। अदर बेसिक टूल्स विच वी हैव डिस्कस प्रीवियसली आर द कंटिन्यूटी एंड द बर्नौली इक्वेशन। द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ इम्पल्स मोमेंटम इक्वेशन लीड्स टू द सोल्यूशन ऑफ प्रॉब्लम इन फ्लूइड मैकेनिक्स विच कैन नॉट बी सॉल्व बाई एनर्जी प्रिंसिपल्स अलोन। सो समटाइम्स इट इज यूज इन कंजक्शन विद द एनर्जी इक्वेशन टू ऑब्टेन कम्प्लीट सोल्यूशन ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग प्रॉब्लम्स। दिस मोमेंटम इक्वेशन इज बेस्ड ऑन लॉ ऑफ कंजर्वेशन ऑफ मोमेंटम और विच इज ऑल्सो नोन एज मोमेंटम प्रिंसिपल। And this momentum principle states that the net force acting on a mass of fluid is equal to change in momentum of flow for a time in that direction. As we all are familiar with Newton's second law of motion, that F equals to ma, force acting on a fluid mass m, is given by this equation. Here a is acceleration acting in the same direction as force F, and as we know that acceleration is rate of change of velocity, so this Newton's second law can be written as F equals to m dv over dt or equals d mv over dt. So F equals d mv over dt. This equation is known as momentum principle, and this equation can also be written as F into dt equals d mv. This is known as impulse momentum equation, which states that impulse of a force F acting on a fluid of mass m in a short interval of time dt is equal to change of momentum d mv in the direction of force. This product of mass into velocity is known as momentum, and d is for differential, or it represents change. So F into dt equals change in momentum. So what are the applications of this impulse momentum equation? This equation is used in the following types of problems. Number one, to determine the resultant force acting on the boundary of flow passage by a stream of fluid as the stream changes its direction, magnitude, or both. Problems of this type are pipe bends, reducers, moving vanes, and jet propulsions, etc. Number two, to determine the characteristic of flow when there is an abrupt change of flow section. Problems of this type are sudden enlargement in a pipe or hydraulic jump in a channel, etc. Now we will discuss force exerted by a flowing fluid on a pipe bend. Before going into the expression or before deriving the formula, first we have to study this figure. This figure represents force on pipe bend. This is a pipe which is bent and at an angle theta. And we have to find out the resultant force exerted by the flowing fluid on this pipe bend. Consider two sections. This is section 1 and this is section 2. So V1, P1 and A1 will be the velocities of flow, pressure intensity, and area of cross section at this section 1, and V2, P2 and A2 will be the corresponding values at this section 2. So Fx and Fy, these are the components of the forces exerted by flowing fluid on bend in x and y direction. Then the force exerted by bend on the fluid in direction of x and y will be equal to fx and fy, but in opposite direction. Hence, component of force exerted by bend on fluid in x direction will be minus fx, and in y direction will be minus fy. The other external forces acting on the fluid are P1A and P2A on sections 1 and 2 respectively. These are the pressure forces acting on section 1 and 2, then the momentum equation in x direction, we can write as using this principle. Here, x component velocity v1 is acting in the x direction and its y component is 0, but we have to resolve this velocity v2 in its x and y components. So its x component will be v2 cos theta and y component will be v2 sin theta. Similarly, p2 a2, this is acting at an angle theta, so its x component will be p2 a2 cos theta and y component will be p2 a2 sin theta. So net force acting on the fluid in direction of x will be equal to rate of change of momentum in x direction according to the impulse momentum equation. So we will enter its values. What are the forces? The forces are P1A, this force, minus P2A, this force acting in opposite direction, minus Fx, and this is equals to mass per second into change of velocity, or this is rate of change of momentum, since mass does not change according to law of conservation of mass. The only change will be in the velocity, so we have written as mass per second into change of velocity. So mass per second, we can write it as rho into q, and change in velocity will be final velocity in x direction minus initial velocity in x direction. So we will enter the values of final and initial velocities. Final velocity is v2, but we have to take its x component, so it will be v2 cos theta minus initial velocity is v1, which is acting in x direction. So upon arranging this equation and finding the expression for fx, we get fx equals to rho q into v1 minus v2 cos theta plus p1a1 minus p2a2 cos theta. Similarly, we can write the momentum equation for y direction. So in y direction, the p1 component will be 0 as it is acting only in the x direction, and P2 component will be taken in the y direction, which will be minus P2 A2 sine theta minus Fy is equals to rho q into V2 sine theta minus 0. This is same as rate of change of momentum or mass per second into change in velocity, and velocity will be final velocity in y direction minus initial velocity in y direction. So there is no y component of v1, so it will be 0, and y component of v2 is v2 sine theta. So upon arranging the equation for and getting the expression for fy, we get fy equals rho q into minus v2 sine theta minus p2 a2 sine theta. Now, in order to compute the resultant force acting on the bed, we will get the expression as Fr equals under root Fx square plus Fy square, and the angle made by the resultant force with the horizontal direction will be calculated by using the formula tan theta equals Fy over Fx. Now, we will solve a related numerical. A 45 degree reducing bend is connected in a pipeline. The diameter at the inlet and outlet of the bend being 600 mm and 300 mm respectively. Find the force exerted by the water on the bend if the intensity of pressure at inlet to bend is 8.829 Newton per centimeter square and rate of flow of water is 600 liters per second. आपके पास एक पाइप है, उसमें एक रिड्यूसर आपने लगाया हुआ है और एंगल उसमें आपका बन रहा है 45 डिग्री. सो जो आपका मेंशन है कि रिड्यूसर है, इट मींस कि स्टार्ट में आपका डाया ज़्यादा होगा और रिड्यूसर के बाद डाया कम हो रहा है. तो स्टार्ट में आपके पास डाया है 600 मिलीमीटर एट द सेक्शन 1 एंड एट सेक्शन 2 द डाया ऑफ पाइप इज 300 मिलीमीटर. You have to find the force exerted by water on the band if intensity of pressure at inlet is 8.829 Newton per centimeter square and discharge is 600 liters per second. So First of all, we will calculate the areas at these two sections by simply using the formula pi by 4 d1 square and pi by 4 d2 square. So at section 1, area comes out to be 0.2827 meter square, and at section 2, area is 0.07068 meter square. Convert pressure intensity into standard units. So it is 8.829 into 10 power 4 Newton per meter square, and discharge divided it with 1000 and converted into standard units of cubics, which becomes 0.6 cubic meter per second. Now from this discharge, we can calculate the velocities at these two sections by using the formula Q equals to AV, and then we will apply the Bernoulli equation to find out the pressure at this section, and then we will apply the impulse momentum equation to calculate the force. So using the equation of Q equals to AV and entering the values of discharge and area of cross section at section 1, we get velocity at section 1 equals 2.12, and at section 2 the velocity is 8.48 meter per second respectively. Now applying the Bernoulli equation at these two sections, P1 over gamma plus V1 square over 2G plus Z1 equals P2 over gamma plus Z2 plus V2 square over 2G. Since the elevation is same, so it will be cancelled out, and we will enter the remaining values, and we will get pressure intensity as 5.557 meters of water, or pressure intensity as 5.45 into 10 power 4 Newton per meter square. Now force on the band in x and y direction will be calculated by using the equations which we have derived. So fx equals to rho q into v1 minus v2 cos theta plus p1a1 minus p2a2 cos theta. Now we have all these values, we will enter it in this equation. Density of water is 1000, discharge is 0.6, v1 and v2 we have just computed, theta is given, this is 45 degree, p1 is given, area we have calculated, minus p2 we have calculated using Bernoulli equation, a2 we have calculated, and theta is again 45 degree. So upon simplifying, we get fx equals 19911.4 newtons, and similarly we can compute Fy, which comes out to be minus 6322.2 newtons. Negative sign means that Fy is acting in the downward direction. Now we will calculate the resultant force using the formula Fr equals Fx square plus Fy square under the root, and the resultant force comes out to be 20890.9 newtons. So the angle made by resultant force with x-axis will be calculated by tan theta equals Fy over Fx, and then theta will be tangent inverse of this value, which so the theta comes out to be 17 degree and 36 minutes.